when the AI ML based verification is involved, there is no discretion. It's ruthless. If you show one certification which is not belonging to you, or you show one experience or one project that you have not done, but you actually reflected, it can be very damaging. You employ a person, he is under clean exit, and he is supposed to have your laptop, and when he goes, he is supposed to hand it over. The inventory is supposed to be handed over. If he is not handing over, you report it to clean exit. Clean exit will get you the insurance money.
Hello all. Today we have with us Group Captain Anand Naidu, who is the Founder Director of Clean Exit Consultancy Private Limited, which is a work ethics training and rating platform for students and working professionals. Clean Exit is an incubation of Information Sharing and Analysis Center, which is India's leading non-profit advancing professional ethics and cybersecurity, where Sir is serving as a director. Group Captain Naidu served the Indian Air Force for 30 years, where he was the director personnel. He later served Prasar Bharati as an additional director general. He is an adjunct professor at Center for Aerospace and Defense Laws at Nalsar University, teaching aviation and technology laws. He is a transactional practitioner with Akash Law Firm in New Delhi. Today, we are going to talk about how ethics and why ethics is the new oxygen for taking our nation to new heights. Welcome, sir. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you very much, Raja. It's a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you for inviting me.
So, sir, you know, I'll straight away jump to the question, sir. The first question is, with respect to ethics, why is it something that needs to be treated as a separate subject? Aren't we as humans, you know, just wired to understand ethics and find out who's unethical? Isn't it, you know, something we already take for granted?
Yes, we take it for granted, and that is the problem. Taking it for granted, we are not realizing that the greed is actually becoming more predominant. And we are forgetting the basic regulations that are supposed to be regulating our own conduct. I'm not talking about the morals here. I'm talking about the society and the regulating the conduct of human beings. It is very essential. We are seeing the corona pandemic. The pandemic times have actually shown a different side of many people. Many of the persons across the world are suffering because of greed of people and unethical practices that have been, you know, unleashed over the humanity. That is why professional ethics especially is very, very essential today.
But sir, you know, we are a country based on faith and religion. Do we need a separate code of professional ethics? Are, you know, there such codes abroad? Is there an international code like this which exists, sir?
When we talk about religion, when we talk about faith, you know, they are all well in place. I will not talk about ethics in the society, but I will be talking, limiting myself to professional ethics at workplace, because that's where we are focusing on. Two, we have cross-section of people from different religions, different faiths, different customs, different acceptance of beliefs. Now, when we have different cultures coming together, different orientations coming together, there is a need for acceptable and accepted behavioral pattern in the workplace. Otherwise, there will be conflicts. Professional ethics codes are there for different, like doctors, we have the Hippocratic Oath. The lawyers have an act on it. Okay. So for every profession, there is a code. Like for instance, engineers. All the engineers are supposed to be taught ethics as part of the Washington Accord. We are signatory to that. But unfortunately, we have not had that subject being taught as it should be taught. Secondly, you will be surprised that till recently, the school curriculum did not have ethics as part of the syllabus. Only the new education policy now has again reinforced the need to teach ethics even from the school level. So there is a need for us to actually speak about it more open. You know what is happening? All the surveys across the world, it could be perception only. I'm not saying all that is true, But even if an iota of truth is there in that, they are not speaking very well of Indian workforce when it comes to ethics. We are appreciated for our knowledge. We are appreciated for our ingenuity. But at the same time, that zugard, ingenuity of the extreme, is actually causing a lot of difficulty. That's where the problem is. That's why there is a need for us to reorient ourselves on these ethical issues at workplace. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So you mentioned about the Washington Accord, sir. How is Washington Accord related to what is being done at Clean Exit, sir?
Okay, now I'll tell you. The Washington Accord requires common standards for engineers across the world so that engineers from a particular country are accepted at par with other engineers. So they said workplace ethics have to be taught at par with the core subjects that are there for the polytechnic students as well as engineering graduates. Now we have signed that, and there are agencies which are supposed to be implementing that. For some reason, we could not implement it. Now, when we went to AICTE with a proposal for cybersecurity, the discussion came about the ethics and how we implement ethics at workplace for the cybersecurity professionals. That's when we said we have this process where we clean exit them. That means we put them through a series of processes. So then the chairman AICTE said, okay, extend it to other areas of work as well. That's how the clean exit now is extending the processes that are part of the clean exit. There are various processes. Those processes to all segments of workforce. That's what it is.
What is the most simple explanation of clean exit? Is it a checklist? Is it a certificate? Is it a course? Is it a complete framework or a complete system? Can you please explain this, sir?
Okay, clean exit means different things to different set of people. AICTE wants it to be taken to the students of the AICTE affiliated institutions, where for the AICTE affiliated institutions, which means the pharma institutes, which means the engineering colleges, which means the management institutes, which means the polytechnics, for all of them, it is given free of cost by clean exit. The e-learning model of ethics training is available free of cost for them. Okay, that's part of the training. Now, training, when I talk about, there are three modes. One mode is what I said, e-learning. The second mode is what we conduct monthly workplace ethics training, instructor-driven program. That is the second mode. Third mode is where we go to on-site. That means the colleges or offices or organizations, companies, they request us to come and deliver these programs. We deliver them. As of now, it is not there because of the corona pandemic. But otherwise, we go on site and deliver. So these are the three modes in which we conduct the training. That is the training part. That is one part. And the next process is in the clean exit, we have certification. The certification is approved under the NEET 2.0 program of AICTE, which is a Ministry of Education program, wherein the certification, there is a fee, 300 rupees fee. An individual can directly come and go for certification without even undergoing the training. Or alternatively, the students of AICTE affiliated institutions can take the e-learning training model. Through that mode, they get trained and then they can take the exam. Or if the students or any professionals are getting trained through our monthly training programs, instructor-driven programs, they can go for the examination. This examination will lead to certification. The certification is valid for 1 year. The next process that we have is fidelity guarantee, wherein a professional who is joining a company is guaranteed by a public sector insurance company for guaranteeing against his misdeeds. That means, say, for example, you employ a person, he is under clean exit, and he is supposed to have your laptop, and when he goes, he is supposed to hand it over. The inventory is supposed to be handed over. If he is not handing over, you report it to clean exit. Clean exit will get you the insurance. Similarly, if your employee is supposed to give you 3 months notice and he does not give 3 months notice and go away, the clean exit will make sure that the insurance compensates you so that you are not getting into losses. Then we have the career protection. Career protection process is for both students as well as for the employees. Now, how career protection works is, for students, they have engineers are supposed to undergo 4 internships in the process of completing graduation. Now those internships, when they go to the companies, companies have to trust these people. These people have to be protected. That's how we give the career protection from them for them during the studentship. Thereafter, when they join the company, the companies also need to be protected against misdeeds by these people. And these people are supposed to be protected. Their careers are supposed to be protected against any vengeance or vindictive actions by the managers. So that's where the protection is. Then we have something known as exit talk. Most of the companies today do not have established HR systems, especially these small and medium companies. They don't have, the founders are acting as HR, founders are acting as technology heads and everything all in one sometimes. So how do they get the specialist advice? And especially how do they get best out of an employee who is leaving them in the process of leaving? So we conduct the exit interview on their behalf and give them valuable inputs from the employee who's leaving, because the person who is leaving knows many things about the company. What are the best things that can be done to improve the company's functioning? He is in a better position to advise. So that valuable input we take it to. These are the process of clean exit.
So, so this is something like a CIBIL rating system for employees and for people. If I understand it right, sir.
That's exactly what the objective is. The rating that we are talking about, the individual employee being able to rate the company and managers, the managers and the company being able to rate the employee and create an environment of ethical practices at workplace. That's how it is.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So, sir, is this clean exit only for the private sector, or also does it work for the government sector? And is clean exit a government approved system? Do you see it becoming India's national model of rating framework for ethics? Please tell us about it.
Okay, now the clean exit has two elements to it inherently. One is at the individual level. The other one is at the vendor level, at the organization level. That means, say, for example, you have a company and the company employs, say, one company outsourced for, say, HR services. Now, how that company is performing has to be rated and kept record of, so that when next year or next time there is a tendering process, if there are any misdeeds that have been conducted by this company, we should have a record of that. So that is at the vendor level. Individual level is employees and students. Now, vendor level, definitely it is applicable to all the government agencies also, and corporates equally. For the individual level, the employees who are on contractual basis, like we have Government of India or state governments employing huge number of people on contract basis. Most importantly, the data entry operators, the people who are handling computers, the contractual engagees, the casual employees, the vendors who are maintaining our systems, our computers and things like that, those people have to be put through certain training as far as ethics is concerned, and put through certain processes where they are careful about what they are doing, and inadvertently they should not leak data, they should not sell data, they should not indulge in frauds, they should not indulge in any misdeeds that cause damage to the organizations, whether it is a government or private. So it is equally applicable to the government organizations as well as the private companies, including small companies where 10 people are employed or 5 people are employed. Actually, it becomes more critical there. So it's applicable whether it is a petrol pump where there are 10 people who are working there, or a cinema hall, for example, or a chain of the shops. So anywhere and everywhere, say, for example, a company like Malabar, the gold, they have a different system of rating. They already have. So we can actually integrate our system there. That's what it is. So it's applicable to government as well as private.
So, sir, there's this important point about, fake resumes, fake experience letters, face other misrepresentations with people, when they're applying for a job, they do all these things. So why should a person choose honesty? Will he be selected if, he's, competing against all the other applicants who have done all misrepresentations? So how does the person deal with this situation, sir?
Okay, now I fully agree with you. Yes, because the number of jobs which are available are very less and the contenders are very many. Because of that mismatch, there is a tendency for the people to actually bloat up or muscle up the resumes, or show fake certifications, show fake experience and things like that. I agree with you, it's happening. But what happens is today, Raja, what is happening is across the sectors, the recruiters are more and more relying on artificial intelligence and ML for their recruitment process, especially the verification of credentials, background physical verification. We're talking about online verification. We're talking about certifications being verified. We're talking about certifications and the experience certificates being verified. When the AI ML based verification is involved, there is no discretion. It's ruthless. If you show one certification which is not belonging to you, or you show one experience or one project that you have not done, but you have we've actually reflected, it can be very satisfied. Sustainability lies in being ethical. If the companies have to sustain, we have to be ethical. The other side of it is, what is happening? Why the salaries in India are a little lower than across the world is because the fraud levels are very high. The companies cater for these frauds and leakages, and then the bottom lines are going to be less. The profits are less, so they give lesser salaries. But the moment you have this leakage plugged in, if it is stopped, what will happen is the profits will go up. Obviously, the companies will share that profit with the employees through bonuses, through higher salaries. So there is benefit in being ethical. That's what we have seen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So, sir, you know, there's another critical issue, some little sensitive issue that is regarding women at the workplace. India has laws passed on it. So, sir, does this clean exit system deal with women's rights and prevention of sexual harassment at the workplace? And does it also comply with all the relevant laws, sir?
Yeah, you know, when I talked about training, that is the first process in clean exit. Now, training, whether it is for the students or the professionals, whether it is online training through e-learning module or through the instructor-driven program or on-site when we go and conduct programs, there are various elements that are covered in this training. One important thing is gender sensitivity, culture sensitivity, age sensitivity. These are all very, very important topics that we cover. Now, POSH, prevention of sexual harassment at workplace, is a very important topic, especially because, you know, in Indian context, we look at genders differently than in the Western concept. So the equality part does not come naturally to us because of our societal value systems. So we insist on them to be careful. Similarly, a girl and a boy, when they are classmates in college, they can behave differently. The same behavior, the day they join the company, say both of them join the same company, their behavior, same behavior here, can become objectionable. That's why we give a lot of emphasis on the sensitivity part and training them on these issues. Yes, it is.
So you've spoken, you know, a lot. Thank you so much. Spoken a lot about professional ethics. You spoke about clean exit and how it is going to provide solutions to all the problems that we have highlighted today, sir. Now, my request to you would be, sir, please give a message to all the viewers who are listening and watching this video.
My simple message is like this. Ethics first and always. Be ethical. The companies will be sustainable. You can definitely gain out of it. That's one. Two, we have seen being unethical, how things have been damaged and how a lot of damage has been caused across the sectors. So the time has come now for professional ethics to take priority on all other things. And companies are saying that they won't mind employing an ethical employee rather than an unethical employee who is very competent. So that's what they are saying, and that's what will happen in future. And with AIML coming into play, I think one can't afford to be unethical. That's as simple as that. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. It was a very good message for all our viewers that it is the time for ethics now, and we have to adopt ethics. Thanks a lot. We are really, really thankful to you for throwing light on this very important topic, sir. We are really, really grateful. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Raja. It's a pleasure. Thank you very much. Thank you.